half of the group stage, well, second half of the group games today now. And it is Liverpool versus Napoli. Now in the IRL Champions League, Napoli beat Liverpool, and that was the opening group game. Whereas here, they're waiting until the second group game before they clash. Here we go, Samara with the shot. Retro tries to steal it. Nothing came of it. And oh, Roger Demorsing retro, but Samara gets the goal for Liverpool. Not what Retro would have wanted, but it's a goal regardless. Well, the shot sticks with the save. Morton Shepherd. And Shepherd makes it two. With the shot, Marley with the save. Well, it may not have been a goal for Retro, but he assisted him. There you go. 3-0 to Liverpool. Nice little bit of redemption. go. And Retro, oh, he got the demolition, but as a consequence, couldn't see where the ball was being aimed. Seconds to go. And sticks. Gets one back for Napoli. And that'll be it. The scoring streak is going to come to an end today. And oh no, is it? No, streak's an end. Retro livid with himself. He really wanted that streak to continue. But he'll take the assist. And it's 3-1 to Liverpool. Next up, Red Bull Salzburg and Genk. In their last group games, Salzburg 2-0 win against Napoli. Genk lost 2-1 to Liverpool. And this arena modelled after the Neo Tokyo arena, which, as we all know, Retro doesn't have the best track record with. Had a shot. With a point to prove, he may not have scored in the last game, but he gets one right out the gate. Raja gets the equaliser. Raja, that's another one for Salzburg. Retro, there's another one, and there's the equaliser. Robert Drexel clearing it away. Retro gets the hat trick. There's no stopping his momentum right now. He scored in 8 of the 9 group games. He scored in 8 of the 10 group games. Is on fire. Retro clearing it away. Go. No way! What?! Five goals today! Is there no stopping them? There it is. On to Group F now. And it's Barcelona versus Borussia Dortmund. Thank you. And Sabretooth puts Borussia Dortmund ahead. These two both won their first group game. We 2-2 Borussia Dortmund against Inter Milan, and Barcelona with a 2-1 win over Slavia Prague. A minute and a half gone, it's still 1-0 to Dortmund. Retro went for the shot, Sabretooth with the save. Get anything done there. And Retro, there's another one! 10 from 11. Is one apiece as we head into the closing stages of this game. Basket had a shot. Nothing came of it. Wrong sport. Retro is just in a league of his own right now. I'm done. I'm done. There's no stopping Retro right now. There is no stopping him. Go. Next up, it's Inter Milan and Slavia Prague. Fort Wheels Arena. See from Dude on Raja's shot. Went for the shot. Dude gets the shot. He gets the goal. Retro with the assist. Gets the equaliser, one apiece. Retro went for the shot. Couldn't get it in. Could be a little annoyed with that one, and I wouldn't blame him. Now still one apiece, and of course if it's a tie after the hour mark, after the full time whistle blows, there is no overtime in the group stages. And Tusk gets the goal, and Retro gets another assist. Well, Retro's not able to get any goals today. That's his third assist. Very happy with that one. Is a win for Slavia Prague. Next up, it is Benfica versus Zenit St. Petersburg. Both games in this group ended in a draw. Benfica Lyon 3 each. Leipzig and Petersburg. Imp gets a goal for Benfica. And Dude gets the equaliser. The town with the own goal. Not what he would have wanted. Dude gets another one. Chipping with the shot, Hound with the save. Hound with the shot, Armstrong demolished by Retro. Imp with the assist. And Retro helping get Benfica back on level terms. With the shot, dude, great save. Leon and Leipzig next. Great save from Heater on Poncho's shot. Retro demolishing Poncho there. Could definitely use one of those right now in this weather. And Sabretooth puts Leipzig 1-0 up. Sabretooth gets another goal. Roman Demolition Tusk. Demolition on Poncho. Bowman with the shot, nothing came of it. Retro with the shot, Gerwin with the save, and oh, and Gerwin gets the goal. Position ruining Rector's chance of getting a goal. He hasn't scored in the last two games. And we could be on the verge of them. Preventing Rector from scoring a third! Thank you. three games in a row that Retro has failed to score. While it may be a win, Retro walked away without any goals for the third game in a row. Retro will have to play for Chelsea against Ajax. Both these games, teams won their last game. Ajax 3-0 against Valencia and Chelsea 2-0 against Lille. And Rainmaker already puts Ajax ahead. That is slightly concerning. Shot there, he got bumped out of the way. And Retro scores for Chelsea and gets them level. Well, he gets it. He was concerned he wasn't gonna get it, but he gets it anyway. Oh, that was where he was going to make a mistake. But a little help from Hollywood, and there you go, 2-1 to Chelsea. Quite correct the course of the ball. Come down. The shot, Scout with the save. Oh! Defense playing havoc with the team. Playing havoc, especially with Retro. And Hollywood takes the shot. Retro with the assist. There you go. 3-1. Retro gets another one. There's the hat trick. And Hollywood, assisted by Scout, makes it 5. Rainmaker gets a second for Ajax, but it's not going to be enough. Tamara credited with the assist. And there you go. And Sundown preventing Retro getting another goal. Why did Retro stop? But nevertheless, a hat trick for Retro, and it's 5-2 to Chelsea. One game to go. And it's Valencia versus Lille. Incredible save from Iceman on Yuri's shot. Another save, Iceman on Stinger this time. Thank you. Another fantastic save. The Lille defence not giving an inch. And Retro, oh no! Sort of thing he really could have done without. And that's life, as Frank Sinatra once put it. Retro, there's the equaliser! Scored in 13 of the 16 group games today. With 8 in a row. Another shot there, trying to put Valencia back ahead. Jury demolished by Retro.
60 seconds left on the clock.
And Poncho puts Valencia ahead. With the save on Iceman's shot. About 30 seconds left to go.
8 seconds left on the clock.
Sold out Champions Arena. Can Lille force a draw in the dying seconds?
The game was lost.
So we are now going to get into the standings after the second match day. Real Madrid at the top of their group after their win. Club Brugge in second based on their win against Galatasaray. In Group B, Red Star Belgrade, top of their group, and Olympiacos ahead on the tiebreaker after beating Tottenham Hotspur. Manchester City, top of their group, Dynamo Zagreb in second place after their win tonight. In Group D, Bayer Leverkusen and Atletico Madrid are in their respective, Bayer Leverkusen leading with Atletico second based on goals scored. Liverpool top of their group with Genk in second again, it's on a tie break, interestingly, but that doesn't mean anything. But of course, not only did they beat Salzburg, but they are ahead on goal difference as well. Barcelona, with their win, puts them ahead in the group. Slavia Prague ahead on goal difference. Leipzig, with their win tonight, puts them top of the group. Lyon down at the bottom. Benfica second on goal difference. And Chelsea top of their group. And Ajax ahead on goal difference. So that is it today, folks. Hope you enjoyed what you saw. If you did, as always, hit the thumbs up. And if you want to be baptized into following this channel, hit the subscribe button down at the bottom. Click the bell to join Latter-day Saints notifications, so you don't miss anything I do on this channel. I've got the groups A through D on the left, Rocket League Season 6 playlist on the right. It's reaction day tomorrow. And what am I going to be reacting to? Well, you'll need to wait and see. Until then, enjoy the rest of your day. Peace out. And as always, stay faithful.